outsiders as second class citizens. Now they have come to the center stage and they are now in fact VIP labor in the country. And many employers say that they should not leave the place. If they leave, that will be a great loss to them. That position has come up. Now it's a fact that there is psychological and social issues among the migrant workers. They are very badly placed in many states. Their living condition is very poor. In many states, the contractors, they abandoned these people. Principal employers also abandoned these people. And they are living at the mercy of trade unions, service organizations, government agencies. That is the pitiable conditions. They are also worried about their family members in their villages. So there is a sort of panic. So nobody should prevent them going back to the home states. That is inhuman. So the only option now left to the industry is to give some incentives so that these people come back or they stay back at their workplaces. Wherever there are good employer-employee relationship, there the migrant workers are staying back.
Now, the government has made it mandatory under the National Disaster Management Act for companies not to lay off employees. Despite that, we know that mass retrenchments are taking place. You referred to that in your first response. More than 110 million people laid off just in the month of April. What are your suggestions at the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh to try and ensure that this doesn't go on in this way?
Now, at the earliest, the economic activity has to be reinstated. So the government has to do whatever they can do for all these things. Next is availability of raw materials is a big issue now. They are not getting at the cost which they were getting previously. Then payment of wages, that also has become an issue. So what we have suggested to the government is let the employers pay the wages and the government should subsidize, especially the small-scale industries. MSMEs, the government should subsidize their wage bills. That is our proposal we are going on.
What are you making of the intervention so far? The policy thrust of the Prime Minister speaking of very substantial land labour reform. Now, I know that the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh has opposed what the government of Uttar Pradesh has done, where majority of the labour laws have been suspended. Can you explain what your opposition is, what your fear is?
Now, day before yesterday, the Prime Minister's speech, we find a substantive shift in the government policies regarding to stimulus package. Previously, the stimulus packages the benefits were given to big industries, corporates, etc. This time, the thrust has gone to the real wealth creators of the country, that is labor, farmers, and the small industries. This is a wonderful change in the policy of the government, and this is really going to bring back the economy in the previous form, and it may also lead to India into its excellence. So we have welcomed that thing. That is a thrust to labor, farmer, and small industries. That is they are the backbone of India's development. They are the three pillars upon which India's development is resting.
The Uttar Pradesh government has changed labor laws. What are you making of the suspension of a majority of the labor laws in Uttar Pradesh?
Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, and Gujarat. These are the three states where ordinance were promulgated or they were prepared there to get the assent of the president. So these are very unprecedented steps taken by these state governments. It is something unheard in the history of India, and it is also unheard. It is very rare even in most undemocratic countries in the world. So this we have to realize. So BMS have taken a step that these three ordinances have to be withdrawn. Otherwise, BMS will go for national-wide agitation. This stand we have taken. Now, the question is, this is not labor reforms. There is no reforms in it. It is a wholesale burial of all the labor laws in the states. Except three or four labor laws, all the labor laws are withdrawn in a wholesale manner. They're all buried. It is like in Italy, when people died on COVID, all they were put in the trucks and put in pits and buried. In the same way, all the labor laws are buried in these three states. This is something beyond all tolerance limit. So we have decided to fight against it.
Now, you're saying you will fight the changes in these states, but the government's logic is that at a time when industry is down, it's better to allow them to fire half their workforce and keep the company running with the remaining 50% than to have the company itself shut down. That seems to be the logic which is creating space for more flexibility in labor laws.
That theory has been taken care of in the discussions.
Okay, we lost that line. Give us a minute. What we've just heard from Saji Narayanan is very crucial. He says that there will be a nationwide agitation by the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh. Now, this is an affiliate of the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, the three major trade union organizations. One is run by the Congress, which is the ITAC. Then there is C2, which is run by the left parties. And then there is the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh. I'm told Mr. Narayanan is back. The logic behind your opposition, because this can help companies from otherwise completely crashing and burning.
This has nothing to do with reforms. Reforms have been discussed in detail threadbare when the four labor codes were formulated by the central government. There we have suggested, we have opposed many clauses, we have welcomed some the wage code. So these exercises are going on. In between the wholesale withdrawal of these things, that is against the declared constitutional principles. Supreme Court has many times declared that it is against fundamental rights, directive principles. It is also against 47 ILO conventions adopted by Indian Parliament. So at the global level, ILO has set some international labor standards. No country can go against those labor standards. So we have in discussions in the regarding the labor codes, we have brought all these international labor standard principles and we are trying to settle these issues. It has even gone to the level of parliamentary standing committee. They are also scrutinizing it. All these things, exercises are going on. In between, there is no need, absolutely no need for these things. In those exercises, even the employer organizations were there. So the wholesale withdrawal of labor laws, this is something, it's inhuman. It is something unheard in the annals of history.
No, but what exactly do you intend to do? Because the Prime Minister also referred to land reform, labor reform. So what's being done at the states seems to have some form of sanction from the central government, if not in the nuance and the minutiae, at least as far as the policy thrust is concerned. You're talking about a national agitation. When do you intend to launch that? And how do you intend to take it from here?
In the country, there are several laws which were formulated 60 years, 70 years back. There are certain laws which are not coping with the new developments. Of course, all the stakeholders should sit together and then change the laws. It cannot be unilateral changing without considering the interest of the stakeholders. That cannot be done. The labor is at stake. You see what happened in Aurangabad. The migrant workers were forced to sleep on railway track. This is the condition. In Visakhapatnam, the safety, all the national safety laws are flouted. So in such a serious situation, the government has to give attention to the protection of labor. That also is very much important. And for bringing investment, other thing, we also welcome those things. But that doesn't mean we should go back to medieval times where there is no law, nothing, and the worker should work like slaves. That cannot be allowed. So we are.
Have you heard? You are in constant touch with members of the government. Have you got any reassurance so far? Because the government, so far, from what we are gathering, seems to be firm on the changes that have been made.
The assurance that we have received is when we had a consultation with the Labour Ministry two times. On May 1st, there was a consultation, and on May 6th, also, all the trade unions were called and consultation was done. There the question was raised regarding whether the central government will bring ordinance or something urgently. The labor minister clarified central government has absolutely no intention to bring any ordinance or any such emergent steps. Everything will come in the normal route only by consultation, by confirming to the ILO norms of consulting with all the stakeholders. The convention number 144 ILO is adopted by Indian Parliament. It says any change in law should be discussed with the trade unions, employer organization, and also all the state governments. Only after that it should be passed. But these are all flouted in the three states.
Okay, you've used some very strong language. You're saying it's a pushback to medieval times. You're saying you'll launch a national agitation. C.K. Saji Narayanan, National President of the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, for joining us in India Today. Thank you very much.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.